குட் மார்னிங் சொல்லு.
குட் மார்னிங்.
குட் மார்னிங் சொல்லு. குட் மார்னிங் சொல்றா.
குட் மார்னிங்.
குட் மார்னிங் சொல்றா.
என்ன வண்டியா போயிடுச்சு.
Good morning, all you beautiful people. This is Sharon Zakaria. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today we are at the beautiful aircon. Check out this kick-ass view, you know, right next to our stay. And this is where we're staying. It's called the Bison Valley Cottage. And we have our own very bison here, Sanu Kumar. And the time's around 9 a.m. right now. And we're heading to the town to go and have some breakfast and probably a bit of sightseeing. So this is where the maps ended last night in the previous video, where we thought that's the stay. Man, we woke up in the last day, it was very cold, guys. You know, we woke up in the morning and it was still very, very cold. Someone managed to have a shower, and luckily our stay has a geyser, so we had a hot water shower. I had a shower. Sanu didn't have a shower. Sanu, you didn't have a shower. Not bad. Just that, you know, someone as tall as me, I have to crouch. Okay, I think you took the wrong route. This is definitely not the vehicle to go off-roading with, because the Himalayan is, you know, apt for it, because... Okay, I forgot about this. The Himalayan is apt for off-roading, and you know, look at him go. So this vehicle can deal with a little bit, you know, a little bit of torture put to it. But this is made for it. Wow, the road literally went down like this and it's going back up again. So this also is an estate, you know, if you can see the gates here. So we're at the aircard junction right now, the circle, and we're heading back to aircard Kushka Bhai Hotel. Okay, so we just got down to a bit of a photo session. We came back to our stay because lock the room. We came back to the stay because Sanu wanted to take a dump after eating breakfast. And
you had to take a dump, not me.
No. You all don't lie. Didn't you take a dump? You didn't take a dump. Didn't you take a dump? Didn't you take a dump?
Yes, I did.
I mean,
you did, right? But eventually you had to dump.
Wow, what a beautiful view, man. Check this out. I don't know if the place is named after this valley kind of a look. I don't know if this is actually a valley or anything as such, but they call it the Bison Valley. That's what the caretaker at the cottage said. Let's just go down and give it a look. So this is where the trail ends. the end, right?
Yeah, this is the end.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. I wish I had my Jeep here, man. The trail looks beautiful, beautiful to go down. I could go down my Himalayan, but I don't think the owner would have a problem. The person I just spoke to is the owner. Okay, sir. Thank you. The problem with this vehicle is you don't tend to feel too confident with Interceptor off the road. Okay, probably because of its weight, and moreover, I don't know. It's the tires. It's running on Pirellis right now. It's great on the road, and I had no problems whatsoever so till now. But off the road, on gravel, and I don't think this vehicle is meant to perform a lot, because it doesn't feel, you don't feel too confident on it. It's the weight, and moreover, it's probably because I'm not too used to the vehicle as of now. I wish I had my Jeep here, man. Tasco, I miss you. Okay, I think I need to take it a little slow, because I don't know. Our man's having fun with the Himalayan. So there's this church that my dad told me about when I spoke to him in the morning, and it seems there's a tower that they've built next to it. So he asked me to go there and click a picture. So we thought we'd just go there. Go. So there's another trail here. I don't know where it's going to lead to. Let's see where it goes. On the road, this feels beautiful, man. There's nothing. Yeah? There's no other Royal Enfield to compare with it. But I love the Himalayan. If it is this or the Himalayan, for me, an overall performance, it definitely goes to the Himalayan, because it can go on the road and off the road like a charm. But I just wish they gave the Himalayan a better engine. I don't know, Mr. Siddharthlal, if you ever watch this video, if you happen to watch this video, or anyone from Royal Enfield who might be watching this video right now, please give the Himalayan a better engine. Please upsize the engine, probably a 650 like this, a parallel twin 650 like this. It'll be great, man. There's no holding that bike back. That would be a motorcycle that cannot be stopped with a better engine. And moreover, talking about economy, my vehicle, the Interceptor, gave me about 180 kilometers range, whereas Sanu is still running at the full time that he fueled near my house when we fueled together. That's absolutely wonderful. I think the Himalayan is giving a much better fuel economy than the Interceptor. I thought the economy was very bad, but I had a bit of an issue with the fuel tank, because the fuel was evaporating consistently. And I gave it to the Royal Enfield service at Kormangla, and they fixed it for me, and I think they did a good job, because by now everything should have been gone, all the fuel should have been emptied and the vehicle should have gone on reserve, and I'm sure Sanu would have had to push the vehicle, but he's still going, though my fuel gauge is not working too well. It's so nice and quiet here without too many vehicles, you have no clue about how good it feels to to ride through, and to feel that fresh air, like a cold breeze hitting your fingers. Oh man. And I'm putting the Interceptor through a bit of torture, not too much. But trust me, any day for these roads, for patchy roads, for gravel and off-road and mud roads, name it, the Himalayan is the boss there, man. Trust me, I would literally be gliding, and this feels too stiff. Even the front end and the back end. Thank you. So me and Sanu just decided to exchange our motorcycles. He wanted to ride the Interceptor 650 and he's been constantly nagging me since last night. So I gave it to him now and I'm back on my baby. The comfort level is like heaven and earth between both the motorcycles. I'm literally gliding through these patchy roads and potholes here. Oh man. Trust me guys, this is the best motorcycle built by Royal Enfield to take over all these things. But it just needs a better engine. I love the suspensions in this because the travel on it is a lot more compared to the Interceptor 650. And it is just beautiful to ride this, man. The feeling of riding the Himalayan is something else. There he goes. So we just got done visiting the church. We are heading back to our cottage right now and it's a beautiful place. It's getting really, really hot. I think it's a good, the temperature reading on my bike shows 32 degrees. This is one thing I like the Himalayan for. It's got a compass, it's got a temperature reading unit as well. I mean, that's where, those are things that are very much essential when you're doing a long ride. So you can get to know how your bike is performing and you know what are the temperatures around or you know what are the temperatures of the engine. I've taken a couple of nice pictures from the church here. So if you're following my Instagram or if you're not following my Instagram, the link is down in the description box below. Do make sure you click on the link and hit the follow button so that you can watch my feed, you know, you can see my feed with the best of pictures that I click. I'll try giving the Instagram name, my username below, somewhere down on the screen, so you all can type it down. Or if you do not, or if you still can't find my Instagram profile, the link would definitely be down in the description box below. Please do follow to see some exclusive content and to follow me on my stories and my travel and on an everyday basis. Oh man, so much better. So much better. All right guys, so here we go. We're heading back to Bangalore. My GoPro's battery got maxed out yesterday on my way back home, so I had to stop recording. So by the time I got back home, I was very, very tired and I just parked the bike and went back to sleep. So it is 1:12:40 right now and I'm just gonna go and hand the bike back to the the showroom. So let's just give it a start. All right, so we're at the showroom right now. So Akash is not here. He asked me to hand the keys over to someone by the name Ajay. Mr. Ajay. All right, guys. So I just got done giving the motorcycle back to the showroom, and I want to give a big shout out to Hirsa Motors, Lalbagh Road, for giving me the vehicle, for arranging the vehicle. Though they did not have the documents for the first one, they thought of giving me. And I'm really thankful to Mr. Akash, who gave me the bike, who helped me out with giving me the motorcycle for 3 days. He was supposed to give it for 2 days, but he ended up giving it for 3 days. And I'm super glad that he actually did, because I got to have like the utmost fun with the Royal Enfield Interceptor 650. I hope you all liked watching this video. I hope you all found this video helpful enough to make the right decision for y'all, if y'all want to buy it or not. Do click on the link below for my Instagram. It's in the description box below. And thank you so much for watching this video. As always, stay armored and stay protected.